Yo, what's going on YouTube? It's me, DeBolt the Bear again. We have another Xenomorph build for you today. I am going to be playing other killers during the new tome just to try them out. Obviously, we have artists and stuff, but we're still going to focus the YouTube on the Xenomorph builds while we're still doing that. Today, we got the anti-exhaustion build, but before we get into that, make sure to slap a like on the video if you want to see more content like this. Sub if you want to. I appreciate it. It helps me out, and it helps me understand what you guys want to see. But before we spend too much time in the intro, we're going to go over the build. We have a Blood Echo. When hooking a survivor, all other injured survivors suffer from the hemorrhage and exhausted status effect for 45 seconds, and then it goes on a cooldown for 60 seconds. Then we have Genetic Limits. When a survivor finishes the healing action, they suffer the exhausted status effect for 32 seconds. That pushes us into Mindbreaker. While repairing generators, survivors are afflicted by the blindness and exhausted status effect. Any existing exhausted status effect timers are paused while the survivor is repairing a generator. After ending the repair action, the survivor is afflicted by the blindness and exhausted status effect for 5 seconds. Partners great with the rest of this build. Septic Touch. When a survivor performs the healing action within your terror radius, that survivor suffers from blindness and exhausted. These effects linger for 10 seconds after a healing action is interrupted by any means. That pushed us into the add-on, the Molted Skin. After deploying a turret, the deploying survivor suffers from hindered and exhausted for 3 seconds. Partner that with Brett's Cap. Destroying a turret causes all survivors within 16 meters to suffer from blindness for 25 seconds. Essentially, with this build, we want to have them exhausted as long as we can, and if they're touching generators while they're injured, it pauses the timer, and we can get some awesome value out of it. I hope you guys enjoy. I had some fun with this build, and I will see you in the matches. All right, let's go. Home field advantage. Let's get it. So we got the anti-healing build. Sorry, not anti-healing. Anti-exhaustion build. Let's see how it goes. Xenomorph. Nostromo Wreckage. Let's see if we can't find some footsteps. Got some here. Ooh, we got two people. Let's go. Okay, we break that. They got that out quick. We'll give Meg a little slap here. Oh, she drops that. Is she gonna move? She does move. Let's get over here, see what's happening. I think we're good. Ooh, what was that? You trying to get a turret in chase? Let's get some hits, actually. Okay. So we want... Ooh, we don't want to go in the tunnel. So we want to get hits while we can with Fearmonger. I don't even... Mindbreaker is what it's called. It's back to its normal. But we want to get hits with that, and then Blood Echo goes into effect. So if Grasshopper or Claudette has any exhaustion perks, she will not be able to use them right now because of Blood Echo. It makes it so injured survivors are exhausted. I believe. I'm pretty sure that's what it does. So she wanted to go through the main. I didn't really want to do that. So we're going to take a look around, see if we can't find anybody. We find Leon here. Hello. Get a little tag on him. The cat boy. Let's go, Leon. What do you got for me, huh? What do you got? All right. He went all the way around. He's going to circle here. Okay. We get it down because of that. We get it down because of his passing. Let's go. That's two hooks. Ooh, and Blood Echo just goes right back on. So if they, again, if Claudette's the only one hurt right now. But I did hear this cranking away. Let's check this generator. Pop it a little bit. And if they're healing up, Septic Touch and the Genetic Limits should be putting some exhaustion on them too. Let's see what we got here. Nice, we get a little tag there. Get a little tag here, and nice. Nice quick down, dude. That's what we need. Our early game is pretty strong right now. We're really working it. her up on the hook. This gen's still regressing, which is great. I'm gonna head on back over this way. They insta-saved. I see Leon here. Don't see the other person. So we're gonna actually go for Leon. Ooh, we do get the hit, which is nice. Is she gonna take a hit for him? I mean, to be honest, if she does take a hit, she didn't take the hit. Well, that was weird. Why didn't I slow down? Okay, we'll take that pallet. This whole update has kind of been a mess. Alright, you gonna drop this one? You are. I'm gonna go around. I'm gonna break this, and they will have blindness on them now. So if they're running windows or anything, they won't be able to see what they got working here. Nice. Nice. Okay, come over here. Throw him up on the hook. I'm gonna break this pallet here. And mosey on. Ooh, they got that done. Nice. But we have somebody on death hook. All right, we see Claudette. Oh, I stubbed my tail, bro. Oh, she got the stun too. Somebody on death hook at four gens is actually pretty nice. What is up, Rebecca? We do a little tag here, and she is gonna go for the save. Let's get this. We're gonna fake it. Yep. This will be great. We got two injures, and once we pop her up, we'll have Blood Echo. I hear him over here. Yeah, I was about to say. Okay. I might actually, yeah, I'm gonna pop him on the hook. Oh, there's not a hook over there. Yeah, once he goes up, if they have anything, dead hard, any of that, they will not be able to use it. So I'm going to take the down. Actually, she threw the pallet. Ooh, I missed. Yeah, if she had dead hard or anything there, she couldn't use it because Blood Echo. So, I'm not quite sure. Like I said, we won't know until we get to the end game screen if we blocked out anything. This gen is kind of chugging along, though, dude. Anybody need... She's letting herself die on hook, which makes me think that Meg might not be trying to save anyone. Maybe. I don't want to assume anything. That just seems to be the case. Claudette, where are you at? You stayed here. I'm gonna pick you up. And Meg's not injured, but we do get Blood Echo again. We were very fast and efficient this game, and it worked to our advantage. I love it. But as I said, this is a build that you won't notice that you're getting a value out of it unless you see endgame and see if you denied perks or not. But we'll wait and see if Meg ends up going for the save. Just check around. She's letting herself die. This gen's not worked on. No hatch offering. So we just kind of look around a bit. Maybe we find Meg, maybe we don't. Maybe we find Hatch, maybe we don't. It's just kind of a check-in. Oh, and Meg pops out right in front of us. Was she actually going to go for the save? Is that what she was doing there? Nah, I think she was waiting for the door. All right, we actually get that tag. I'm kind of shocked that that hit. And down she goes. That is a 4K. Let's go. Build works perfectly, nothing wrong with it. Just kidding. We'll see at the end game if we have anything. So So it does look like we actually blocked some dead hards, sprint bursts, and background players. So that's always good. I'm glad to see that. We can take a look through the perks and see what happens. Dead hard, sprint burst, background player. We denied them. That's awesome. And we're on to the next game. All right, we got game two. Toba Landing, let's go. Same build, no changes. It worked so well the first time. All right, I see somebody already. It worked so well the first time, I wanted to try it again to see if it was a fluke. I don't know if it was. We're gonna fake here. It's always a risk not tunneling first. I'm gonna be honest, you should always tunnel at the beginning of a match just to get in your power. Though, I did see somebody right away, so I chose not to. That's a judgment call, and I hope it doesn't come back. But you, as you can see, we were able to get a pretty quick hit. Is she going to drop? Oh, no, because I missed. Oh, we do get her. We do get to get her hesitating there. All right. Anybody around? I do see Rebecca over there. We'll pick up. We'll pick up. Unfortunately, the only thing we're going to have value out of right now is Mindbreaker. Aside from that, nothing's going to be, like, we're not going to have any Blood Echo value. Obviously, it didn't go off. Nobody's injured. So, let's see. Insta-save. Just going to tunnel right back and see what we can do here. Alright. Alright, we got a Kate here. Boom. Get some damage down. Okay. Alright, she's taking me to a turret. I'm gonna come inside here. What you got for me? Alright, can I shoot over this? She dodged it. And she's gonna drop. Yeah, Kate knows what she's doing. She knows avoid, play the 50-50. You should always be playing the 50-50 against Xenomorph. You should not camp pallets or get overly greedy. But this chase is taking significantly longer. There's the stutter that has come from this chapter. All right, and she is back in. Let's go. We get the down. Sorry, Adrian. It's time for you to go. Did I hear somebody? I think I did. I don't know where they went. Oh, I heard somebody fall. There. Yep. What are you guys doing down here, huh? This is good. And like I said before, we're not going to get any value out of... I mean, we're not going to know what value we get until we assume at the end game that we blocked some exhaustion. Aside from, she is, like, top cornering, dude. Alright, Blood Echo is still up. So we don't have to worry about background player or anything. It's actually quite nice, I'm not gonna lie. It's nice not having to worry about that. We'll kick this gen. They did heal, which means the healing perks come into play, too. All right, we saw Rebecca here. So we get value out of them not healing. We get value out of them healing. It's just kind of... Oh, I lost her. Scratch marks are killing me. Okay, she went up here. And I missed my shot, bro. I missed my shot. I'm trash. That's crazy. Did that just hit me through the window? That's kind of nuts, dude. Alright, we're going to break chase there. We're spending too long in chases that we don't need to be spending time in. We get them to pop the gen. And, man, dude, I don't know what it is, but I can't hit those today. But we do hit that. She's going to drop. Nice. Very nice. Shack pallet is gone. So we break chase there, keep them injured. They're healing up as well, which is good for us. All right. We're going to break chase onto her. She's not taking the vault. Probably smart. Unfortunately, we do get that hit on her. We're gonna take this area. She didn't run though. Do a little micro fake there. She can't. So if she had anything, no, she could have. Unless she healed that person. If she healed that person, then she wouldn't be able to use exhaustion. If she had anything. It's hard to keep track of all this in my mind. So we got Blood Echo effective on Adrian, the Kate, and then everybody else is not affected by it. But they are affected by Mindbreaker if they don't stop running. Alright, so we have Kate injured. That's who I'm going to go for, because she won't have anything as long as Blood Echo is active. I missed this, unfortunately. What are you talking about? We want to do a little... You'll notice... I see her looking behind her. She looks like a Dead Hard player. So maybe we denied it. Maybe. We'll see at the end game. But we get another hook on her. We're doing pretty well so far. We got 5 hooks at 3 gens. That one's kind of chugging along, though. They still haven't got it done yet, though, which is very nice. We keep denying it. And I do see Jill here. What's up, Jill? Nice try. Alright, we're gonna sneak around here. Not really sneak, you know. Okay. And she... I don't think she really camped a pallet. I think she just made a wrong call. They healed up. Ooh, okay. So we get a hit on her. And when we use this hook here, we'll get Blood Echo. So we can actually get her out of the game if she doesn't have anything. But we also have to find her too. So I don't know where she's at. I'm going to kind of search around. I'm going to guess she's in areas that there aren't any generators. Unless she's on this one. And she is. And she's walking to get... Mindbreaker off, which makes me think that she actually had something. But at the same time, she wouldn't be able to just walk it off because of Blood Echo, correct? I think. Am I thinking wrong here? I'm pretty sure. I just read the perk, but I already forgot what it was. I'm pretty sure it's the injured people don't get... They get exhausted. So, we're going to look over here. They're not going for the save, which makes me think that they're both over here trying to push a gen out. Okay, I do see some scratch marks. I see Rebecca. Rebecca's leave. Oh, they were working on multiple gens. Okay. All right. We're gonna aim and fire. We got her. Let's go, dude. Oh, that feels so good. I don't know. We had to have gotten some value. It just feels like we're not seeing any exhaustion perks at all. Which feels good. I'm not gonna lie. It feels good. Oh, and we find Kate. We're gonna fake this. She's going all the way around. We should be able to get a hit here. We'll wait. We'll be patient. Nice. We get that hit. And... Oh, she kept going. All right. You going to play this pallet? Oh, you're camping it. And you're patient. Ooh, nice. Nice. I like it. That's all right. We'll take that down. That's a big old GG, dude. Holy hell. Like I said, I feel like we had to have gotten value out of this somehow, but we won't know until we actually see the end game stream, end game screen. So, we'll pop in there. All right, and as you can see, we probably denied, well, we didn't see any dead hearts, so we denied 3 dead hearts for sure, I think. And we denied a bounce landing, which I think Rebecca was trying to hit at the end there. But that's crazy. I feel like we did get great value out of it. All right, guys. I'll see you in the next one. All right, guys, that was actually, that worked out way better than I thought it did. Like I said, in the matches, you won't see any of the affected perks or whatnot until the end of the match. You can only assume what you denied, what you didn't deny, but it will be confirmed when you finish the match and you see it. We had a bunch of dead hards that I'm assuming we denied because we saw zero dead hards at all during our matches. And I'm assuming we stopped some of those sprint bursts, but I think this was a successful build. I don't know if I'd run it quite this hard, but I do think in this current meta with background player, this will work effectively. At least Blood Echo and Blood Echo and Mindbreaker, I think, are great paired together, because as long as survivors are sitting on generators, they won't be able to lose that timer as fast as they want to. But as always, if you guys like what you see, make sure to slap a like on the video, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace out, stay safe, have a wonderful rest of your day, night, whatever time it is for you. Peace.